Welcome to Journey with Jazz, grinding in grace. When I think of grace, I think of a deer and like a deer running, having the feet of a deer, that your feet are so light that they're like the feet of a deer. And so when a deer runs, like when y'all watch them run, they're very light, like they're bouncy, but they're not heavy. And when I think of grinding in grace, I'm thinking I'm running still, but my feet are as light as a deer. They're not heavy. I'm not struggling. I'm still moving forward, but it's in grace. The first thing is you have to resist the hustle mentality. Our generation and the one before us is very big on hustling. That is the trend right now. Hustle, 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 grind, grind, grind. And so there is this heavy temptation to just grind all the time. But the fact that our society really enhances that and pushes that can actually make it unhealthy, because you feel like you always have to grind and get things done in order to feel productive, feel successful, look like you're moving. And that's why a lot of times we feel like we have to show people our grind, show people our progression, because us just progressing and moving forward isn't enough. We have to show people. If you really take a moment and just self-reflect, you'll realize, is it really about this goal, or is it more so about the fact that I want to look like I'm succeeding and thriving out here? So resisting the hustle mentality, honestly, the number one way is spending time with God. And when you spend time with God, already you're resting. Already you're taking yourself away from the world and separating yourself from the busyness of life. And you're saying, Lord, here I am. Here's my heart. Relax me, Father. And just doing that. And then once you start talking and confessing about your struggles and confessing about your disappointments and things that went wrong, because sometimes we hustle because we want to guarantee results. And it's crazy because none of this is on my notes. Sometimes we hustle because we are so afraid of failure that I have to make this perfect.
And if I don't make this perfect, then I'm going to fail. And I'm so afraid of this failure that I have to keep working and I have to keep grinding to guarantee these results.
And that actually just made me think about a conference that I'm planning currently. It's still scheduled for April 3rd through 5th, but due to the coronavirus, it won't be on campus. It'll be over the phone. Well, anyway, the last 2-3 weeks of my life, prior to this whole public health situation, I've been working tirelessly on this conference. Writing people, DMing people, texting people, calling people, scheduling meetings, going to schools. And it's crazy because it wasn't until this moment right now that I realized the reason I was doing that is because I was trying to guarantee perfection. And it's so crazy because the whole thing, it's not canceled, but we're going to make it virtual, so it'll be over the phone. But that's like very low scale compared to what it was supposed to be. And like, a part of me feels like, yes, I was supposed to work to lay everything out, but I definitely, it's crazy, y'all. Like, I'm kind of feeling emotional. I definitely feel like I took a lot of it in my own hands, because I know I was in class, like, working on flyers and doing this and contacting people instead of paying attention. And I think that I had this fear of failure. Like, I want everything to be perfect. Like, I needed to prove something. And I wasn't grinding in grace. I was just grinding. I was doing it off my own power, off my own fuel. And now look, like the thing is practically canceled. It's not canceled, but the dynamic is completely different. And that's not grinding in grace. And God is so intentional, because I didn't write any of that in my notes. I did not even plan on telling that. I didn't even realize that until I'm sitting here talking about it. So let's just jump down to God wants us to rest. He does not want us to be anxious. In Philippians 4:6-7, it says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus." And now when I reflect, I realize that I didn't do that. I was very anxious. And instead of going to God and giving my anxiety to Him, I was like, no, like, this is what I'm gonna do to solve this. A problem was presented and I was the problem solver at that moment. And I remember God telling me, you won't be able to do this without me. You won't succeed at this without me. He would tell me and convict me, because I would get into those moments where I would just be working and working and working and not praying. The reason and the first point why I said the best way to resist the hustle mentality is to spend time with God is because when you do that, there's this great exchange that happens. The Bible says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. You have to watch all the things that you're carrying. Examine your life. What do you have on your plate that God is not at the center of? What did you just pick up? There's this exchange that happens when we give God our own yoke and give God our own burden. God says that his yoke is easy and his burden is light. So in exchange, he gives us something lighter, something that's easier for us to carry. And that's when we know that we've been spending time with God, when we don't feel that heaviness, like we just, the weight of the world is on us. When we do it ourselves, we don't have boundaries. We don't stop working. We're up 2-3 o'clock in the morning working because we feel like if we don't do it, then it's not going to get done. We're working tirelessly around the clock. That's not God's will for us because we're doing it to survive. And we may not be looking for food, but we're looking for a particular result. We feel like if we don't stay up and if we don't keep working on this, then we're not going to be satisfied. We're not going to get this result. And the Bible says he grants sleep to those he loves. He wants us to rest. All right, y'all, we about to go to the beach. I gotta hurry up. So when we are working, wherever we are, at work, at our particular jobs, at school, which now nobody really is at, but your vision, your business, your brand, whatever it is, when you're working, think of yourself as a steward over a gift that was given to you, okay? You're not an employee working for a paycheck. It's not input versus output. What I put in is what I get out. It's not. And I say that loosely because people will take that and be like, oh, so we just should expect God to do everything. What about faith? Faith without works is dead. Be very clear that being a steward means you're managing the things that God has given to you. Okay, he's going to bless it. He's going to make it abundant. He's going to make it fruitful and multiply. Not you. You're just stewarding over a gift that was given to you. The Bible says to Adam and Eve, God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and increase in number, fill the earth and subdue it, rule over the fish in the sea and the birds in the sky and over every living creature that moves on the ground. He was telling Adam and Eve, this is what I've given you. I've given you, I don't got corona, y'all. I'm just hot. It's like really hot in this room. He didn't tell them what you put in is what you get out. He's just saying, manage it. Show me that you appreciate it. And that's how I want us to think of every single thing that God has given us. Lastly, move in grace. The best rewards are gifts, not compensation. It feels good when you're rewarded for something that you worked for. Don't get me wrong. But when you have a hustle mentality, you feel like if I'm not doing this, this, and this, then nothing good. I don't deserve anything good. I can't measure my success by external indicators like grades, promotions, and people's approval because I'm not working for those things, but I'm working in what God already gave me. This is why we should move in grace. I know that God is going to reward me for trying, for managing, for persisting, for taking what he gave me and trying to make it better. Just doing that, I'm going to get a reward. It's not input versus output. It's not if I don't do, then it won't happen. We've been given gifts. What have we done? What have we done with what we've been given already? It's not for me to turn to myself and grind it out 24/7. When you do this, you set the tone for success.
So in order for me to have success, I have to grind 24/7.
That's the way you feel like that's the only way that you can succeed, by working tirelessly. But when you set the tone for success by creating and stewarding over what God has given you, now you can manage it and now you can go to him for your answers, for your guidance, and for your results. Think about our salvation, the best gift that we've been given as believers. We never worked for it. God gave us salvation because he loves us. We don't have to work for it. We just have to accept it. I'm just running through my notes because I gotta go. Think about that. The greatest gift that we've been given, salvation, we don't work for. We accept it. We have to approach every other thing like that as well. He's in control of the outcome. You are responsible for the input. I have to go, guys. Thank you for journeying with Jazz. I will catch y'all later. It's our anniversary, so we're gonna celebrate.